For most consumers, a single external hard drive hooked up to their computer might be enough for secondary storage, or maybe even hooked up to their router as a pseudo NAS. But when has enough ever really been enough? After amassing a collection of 5 different external WD MyBook and MyCloud drives hooked up to my network switch, I've decided to start looking at a more advanced and capable solutions. So today we're taking a look at the Synology Disk Station DS216 NAS server. The DS216 is a NAS, or Network Attached Storage Server. It takes the traditional concept of an external hard drive with an Ethernet port to access on multiple computers and adds in so many features. The device can serve as network storage, a print server, an email and internal service directory backups, automatic backups for your pretty much all of your computers, a web cache, or cache as people like to correct me on, as well as a means of getting your USB external hard drives on the network. All bundled up in a sleek and quiet, yet powerful package, running their kick-ass custom Disk Station Manager software. Oh yes, a full-fledged OS right on the NAS. We'll get to that later. Let's chill my geeking out for a moment and take a physical tour of the DS216, which isn't the easiest name to say, neither is Disk Station DS216 as I'm trying to rush it. Let's call it Bus Disk, or no, that doesn't work either. Why? Here we have a black box that's roughly the size of 2 of my WD MyBook Live drives. Matte black covers the entire box, aside from the front panel, which is a glossy black. I'm never a fan of glossy plastic, but this isn't the worst implementation of it. On both sides of the device, we have a Synology logo, which also acts as a slotted vent for the internals. The bottom features the specs and an FCC sticker, boring stuff, a couple more vents, and 4 small, very small, but effective rubber feet. The back of the device features a 92mm exhaust fan, 2 USB 3.0 ports for adding external hard drives or transferring files on or off USB drives, or adding a printer for print server functionality, a gigabit Ethernet port, a Kensington lock, and the DC power input. The DS216 is capable of wireless connectivity with a dongle, but by default it simply connects via gigabit LAN, which will get you the best performance anyway. The front is where we get to the fun stuff. We have 4 LEDs, a general status light, a LAN connectivity, and disk 1 and disk 2 status LEDs. The brightness of these can be adjusted via their operating system. Below that we have a template for what could be an SD card slot, which might be on other models but isn't on this one, along with a USB 2.0 port. Then we have power and reset buttons with LEDs for those as well. Then we get to that glossy panel I was talking about. It fits in between the hard drive mounts by some rubber grips, so a simple pull will remove it. You're not going to break it, it literally just sticks in there, exposing the 2 hard drive sleds. The sleds are indicated by dots for 1 and 2, and they come out with the convenient handle by just pushing the tab at the top. This is a completely toolless process, which is pretty awesome. The drive sleds are even toolless, featuring removable side rails on the sleds. Once you pull those off, the drive comes right out of the sled. This makes drive swapping super easy and fairly quick. Both 3.5-inch SATA 2 and SATA 3 hard drives are supported, as well as 2.5-inch solid-state drives and hard drives. Internally, they get formatted as the EXT4 file system and can be configured using a variety of RAID types. JBOD, RAID 0, RAID 1, Synology's hybrid RAID, which allows you to expand the volume by adding another drive to the system, etc. This is more applicable to models with more than 2 drive sleds, but still a very neat system. My loaner unit came with 2 2TB drives, but you'll need to provide your own, of course. Let's take a look at that OS, shall we? It acts just like a normal desktop operating system would, with an app launcher, a system tray, window management, all within your web browser. When first hooking it up, you should be able to just go to it by going to find.synology.com, create an account, and get set up with the software. From there, you can configure, well, everything. You can set up cloud services to sync with backup shares on the drive, manage users and file shares, get instructions for setting up your file shares on network locations on your local computers, and even set up a malware service to continually run on the drive and make sure nothing you drop in there is malicious. The OS also lets you configure your server as a DLNA media streaming service to stream some media, such as photos or videos or music, to your media player. Keep in mind though, this is knit as a normal file server, not as a media transcoding streaming server, so it's not going to run Plex, it's not going to run Kodi or anything like that. It won't transcode anything at all, it will just stream the original formats. So it can stream to iTunes as well to stream your music library. It can support up to 16 IP cams and 5 connections for a personal VPN as well. Really impressive stuff. Using the NAS for day-to-day storage was pretty straightforward. Once you get everything set up in the software and mounted your network shares, simply copy files over. It has a low power mode that activates after certain lengths of inactivity, but I never experienced any issues with it not wanting to wake up or, you know, turn on whenever I wanted to move files to it or anything like that, which is great because, at least with printers, I've had a lot of issues with that. It has some preset shares for things like music, movies, documents, etc., but you can also just set up your own folder structures and shares for virtually as many users as you want. Well, not unlimited. The user account limit is 2048 with 128 maximum concurrent file transfers. But hey, that's enough for most of us. I hooked the DS216 up to my normal Linksys Gigabit network switch via a Cat6 cable and was getting my usual expected speeds for transfers to my computers, which average roughly between 115 and 150 megabytes per second using TeraCopy. And yes, I do mean megabytes and not megabits. While there are probably ways to get it to go faster, this was plenty fine for me and what I'm used to having between computers. If you get their higher end 4-drive model, it features 4 Ethernet ports and a load balancing capability, so it can actually utilize those 4 LAN connections and get slightly better speeds. Very cool. There's tons of features that I honestly am never going to have time to fully mess with. There's includable downloadable software packages for their OS to extend its functionality with iTunes music streaming, email and support ticket systems, proxy server, WordPress hosting, and even Android apps for managing some of the file streaming and surveillance capabilities. This was a rather long video, as this is a very complicated but badass little box. At this point, it's hard to look at my normal NAS drives and see them as very useful at all. If mass storage drives weren't still out of my price point, I would love to pick up their 4-drive NAS server and load it up with as many terabytes as possible and ditch these individual NAS drives in a heartbeat. As always, product links to this bad boy will be in the description below. Thank you for watching my review of the Synology Disk Station DS216, still having trouble saying that name, a really awesome NAS server. Leave a like if you enjoyed it, make sure to subscribe, and check out my other channels for more awesome videos like my recent microphone reviews or my earbud challenge. Until next time, my name's been Adam Repulse Vox, and I will catch you later.